the back straightaway chicane.
Everybody's doing their best to cause late race caution.
Here we go. Trix gets loose. He understands that the one's trying to compete with him in the braking zone. And they both got in there too deep. Martin broke loose first. Gets sideways into Kurt. Kurt just not wanting to give up the spot.
There won't be a restart. The white flag was taken by Chase Elliott. As he's in the infield part of the course now.
Yeah, I was mentioning, Rick, those 5 pound points will get him the fourth vote. So this win can't help him in the next round. Can't help his path to the championship for Phoenix.
And that now is the goal for everyone. Everyone that's in the top 8 in points now, they are looking forward to the championship four. How do they get there? What do they do in the next 3 races? They've got Kansas, Texas, Spartansville in front of them. They're trying to get to Phoenix. Momentum is also a very big thing in racing. And when you come off of something like what we're seeing Chase Elliott do, it has to give him a nod as far as momentum on his side.
He has the best average running position of everybody in the playoffs, Rick, so he is the hottest driver in the playoffs right now.
And the youngest. 4 road course wins in a row. Chase Elliott's going to do it again at the Roval.
Great job, man. Great job. Awesome job. Appreciate it. Great job, guys.
Think about this. On road courses, his win percentage is 42%. That is an unheard of number. And Chase
Balicki.
A lot of damage to the 51 of Balicki.
It's like you blew a right rear tire at speed. Banking there, back the car around into the left side, driver's side into the wall.
I think the other big story that comes from what just happened here, the finish, the defending series champion, Kyle Busch, is eliminated. He will not have a shot at defending his title. There's Balicki coming through what is NASCAR 4.
Explodes the right rear tire, sinks it under the wall.
So the celebration will begin for Chase Elliott. I mentioned Kyle Busch. And now his focus, which he says his focus this whole year has been on just getting to victory lane. But that is going to take over his entire focus. Getting a win in 2020. Keeping a streak alive that has gone for 15 years. Every year he has been in the Cup Series, he has won a race. He has not been able to win in 2020. Coming in, the playoff standings. No one improved their position. Kyle Busch, Austin Dillon, Clint Bowyer, Eric Almirola, the 4 that were below the cut line, they will be eliminated from the playoff contention. They will not advance into the round of 8. There are the 4, the reset points at 4,000, and then all those playoff points. You guys mentioned the fact that Chase Elliott grabs another 5 playoff points. Those add into his bucket, as we call it, and he will take that into the next 3 races. And he's one step closer to a championship.
Won a lot of races early on, and then it became Harvick and Denny Hamlin for the rest of the year, and that's all we talked about. Now this team here is seeming to peak at the right time. I know it's a road course. That's not where it's going to be settled for the title, but this has got to build a lot of confidence.
Steering wheel off, we'll see Chase Elliott climb out. And the Dawsonville pool room. is celebrating right alongside of Chase Elliott. This time the car's not going to roll back or roll away from him. That has happened before, a year ago, after he won here at the Roval. Grab the checkered flag. Elliott sweatshirt there with the Napa hat. And Chase Elliott fans coming down to congratulate him. And a welcome sound. The fans here at Charlotte Motor Speedway, Dave.